the way to learn Chinese. Chinese pot, Chinese pot, Chinese pot. That's the way to learn Chinese. Hi everyone, welcome back to Your Coffee Break with Chinese Pod. I'm Alice.
Hi everyone, I'm Josh. 欢迎回到中文播客。
In today's lesson, we are going to teach you some helpful business etiquette, especially when it comes to welcoming or sending off your clients.
没错，在中国公司工作的时候，礼貌很重要，特别是见客户的时候，礼貌更是少不了。所以我们今天就要来聊一下，客户进门或是离开的时候，我们要对客户说什么。我们开始吧。
Displaying a high level of professionalism is important in Chinese culture, especially when it comes to your relationship with your client.
特别是第一次和客户见面的时候。
So when your client comes to visit you at your headquarters, you can start by greeting them.
这时候你可以说久仰久仰。久是时间很长的意思。仰是往上看的意思。
So 久 means a long period of time. 仰 means to gaze, especially upwards. So to gaze at someone for a very long period of time would mean to admire this person for a very long period of time. It's a very good way of greeting someone.
没错，你也可以说久仰大名，或是幸会幸会。幸是荣幸的意思，会是见面的意思。
So 幸会 would mean it is an honor to meet you.
再来你可以说毕幸，比如我可以说毕幸范。
毕幸 is a very professional or formal way of introducing oneself. So for example, I can say 毕幸是 which means I'm Miss Xi. Or Josh can say 毕幸范 which means I'm Mr. Fan.
所以在第一次见客户的时候，你可以说久仰大名，毕姓范，这是我的名片，请多指教。
Greetings everyone and welcome to Chinese Pod Trivia. Our first question is, how long will it take you to become an intermediate Chinese speaker using the Chinese Pod app? Is it A, the rest of your lifeB, you should already be an intermediate speaker. C, 3 months. Or D, Chinese Pod has an app?
You should already be in.
Ooh, that is incorrect. The correct answer is C, 3 months. That's right. Head over to ChinesePod.com now to register for your access to over 4,000 lessons. Get the Chinese Pod app now on Google Play or the App Store.
After greeting your clients, you can then welcome them in by saying 欢迎您。
如果客户只有一个人，你可以说欢迎您。如果来了很多人，你可以说欢迎大家的光临。再来，你可以说请进。
So please come in.
如果希望客户坐下，你可以说请坐。
Or please take a seat. And if there are refreshments laid out for your clients,
这时候你可以说旁边有些茶点，请自便或是请随意。
自便 the 便 means at your own accord.
所以请自便意思就是做自己想做的事。
So these two terms would then mean help yourself. And finally, when it comes to sending off your clients, besides the usual 再见, we can also use the following phrases.
你可以说我们后会有期，后是今天以后的意思，会是见面的意思，有期是有这个时候。
So this simply means I'll see you at a later date or I'll see you again.
意思就是我们今天以后还有见面的时候。
And if we want to stay in contact,
你可以说今天很荣幸认识您，希望以后多联系。
So 荣幸 means it's an honor, and 联系 means contact.
你也可以说下次去拜访您。
拜访 is a very common phrase used in Chinese to exchange pleasantries. This simply means next time it's my turn to pay you the visit. In today's lesson, we learned several ways to host your client. Let's do a practice.
好。
So, Josh, if I were your client visiting you at your office, how would you host me?
Ah, Alice, 久仰久仰必姓范，这是我的名片。
谢谢。
请多指教。
请多指教。
欢迎您，请进。旁边有些茶点，请自便。
And after our meeting, when our meeting is finished, how would you send me off?
很荣幸认识您，希望以后多联系，我下次去拜访您。
Will you bring me a gift?
我再想想好了。好的，如果有什么问题，欢迎你们在下面留言，我们很快就会回答你的。我是 Josh.
I'm Alice.
我们下次见。
Bye bye.
As usual, ChinesePod provides an extensive selection of learning materials for this lesson on its website, www.chinesepod.com. You can access this lesson directly with the lesson number
4538.
So just go to www.chinesepod.com/4538 and you will find a transcript, vocabulary, and much more. The link again, www.chinesepod.com/4538.